He messed up. Why is he trying to stop it? Why is this guy trying to stop it?
Video before, so.
Oh yeah, he messed up.
And yeah, still a process, man.
Look how calm he is.
For the record, for my own information, I just arrived here from the United States this morning. My name is Chris Bauer. As I exited my hotel, this gentleman started to follow me around. He was getting very close to me, threatening me.
Yes, because I knew that
he was telling me he was going to take my money for his son because he needed money for his son. And I told him I was not going to give him any money. I asked numerous people throughout the city to call the police and help me. Many people failed. I also have that on video. I entered this store for my own safety. When I entered the store, I asked the staff to call the police. Then this man proceeded to attack me. I took his back. I choked him unconscious. And now I have him in the full mount position waiting for the police to arrive. Thank you, sir. And here comes the police now.
Congratulations. You played yourself.
That guy at the beginning trying to stop it all was just really annoying. So this guy thought it was a good idea to rob a bald guy with cauliflower ears, and he's very calm and composed. Right, that right there is a combination to get whooped. That staff member, imagine being that sort of guy that's trying to stop someone from defending themselves from a criminal. I mean, that guy looked like a right idiot. Just sat there on the floor. He couldn't go nowhere. He was done. And a wise man once told me, never mess with a man with cauliflower ears.
But you kind of, you sound silly.
Like, it's,
you
this sound is absurd silly. On its face.
You sound like What's a that? Silly goose.
I'm sorry, you have a gunt. Like, what do you want me to say?
I have a gun?
A gunt.
Gunt?
Yeah, G-U-N-T. An actual gunt. And I'm not going to take lip from a woman with a gunt, ever.
What does that mean?
I don't think I can give the definition.
Why?
Then Brian, you do it.
I'd rather not, to be honest.
What did that just mean?
I didn't even know what the hell that meant. I'm getting too old for all the social media terminologies we hear. Went to the comments, and what it means is when your gut touches your damn.
My body count is 1,572.
Four digits. Some people don't even have that in a fucking bank account there. Yo, where's the parents? What's going on?
She belongs to the streets.
My God! Just fucking leave women alone. She just wanted to read her fucking book. When you asked her a question and you didn't like the response that you got, instead of accepting her no, you went about convincing her as to why her response to your question was wrong.
Wow, check this out. This is a woman with maxed out misandry stats. And typically when we see rabid feminists, they're younger, Generation Z, millennials. But this fascinating creature here has been able to maintain her male hatred well into her 40s. She should be studied and discarded, catch and release style.
Would you rather be stuck in a forest with a bear or a man?
Oh, a bear. Men are
Why the bear?
Crazy. Crazy. Look at the stories. Men are horrible.
So you're actually more afraid of a man?
Yeah.
Than a bear?
100%. I feel like a bear could have some sympathy.
Will have sympathy?
Yeah. Men are bad.
Would you rather be stuck in a forest with a bear or a man?
A man. The bear's gonna maul you down and absolutely kill you.
Would you rather Callie stuck in a forest with a man or a bear?
A man.
That's
okay.
Not true.
Why do you think women are selecting the bear?
They don't trust men. That's all it is.
This is a girl who never paid attention and listened to her father. More often than not, if you're in the flipping wilderness, a man will more than likely put your survival and your health and your well-being before his, even if he doesn't even know you. That bear will slice you up, one swipe, and you're done. And that bear won't think nothing about it.
I remember telling you that was unavailable.
I said this like 15 times. You can't have my Snapchat. You can't have my number. You can't have access to me because access is denied. You swiped your card like 10 different times and it did not work. What are you telling me? You're still chatting to me?
Yeah.
Why? Why are you doing it? If you get my what?
Number. And then that's a chance of you letting me swipe my card, you know.
I feel like you're intruding on this experience that I'm having right now.
You feel like
I'm flying away and you're just keeping me down here.
Okay, let's fly together.
No.
Yeah, there are some creepy guys out there who will harass women, 100%. Everyone's given a stick in the comments, but we don't know. That guy could be flipping 6'5", 300 pounds. He could have a crazy look in his eye, whatever the case may be. And if she says the wrong thing, he might attack her. I don't think it's really fair to give her a stick. She said no more than once. One no is enough. And these losers need to just keep it moving.
How do I tell my girlfriend she has bad breath?
I went on a date one time and I told her straight up. I said,
"What?"
Yeah, yeah, I told her.
No, you've actually just got to say
yeah,
you've got bad
say,
breath.
Yeah, yeah,
hold
yeah.
up, what did you do on your date?
Nothing. I just told her. I was like, "Listen, you actually have really bad breath."
On the first date?
No, it wasn't a date, but we were dating. But then I told her eventually.
Yeah, but how did you say? Like, can you tell?
Yeah.
Paint the
how
picture?
Did you say it?
We were lipsing, and then one time, we were lipsing, and then I just turned away, and then she just clocked.
But then, like, and then did you say your breath is stinking?
Yeah, I was like, listen.
Yeah, I mean, I've been there and done that myself. I don't know about you guys, but I don't care if she's a flipping 10 out of 10, the prettiest girl on earth, looks like she's been carved out of flipping stone by angels. If her breath is howling, that's a no-go for me. I can't do that, man. You need to have a relationship with Colgate. I ain't trying to do that.
Do you think you're a toxic guy?
Right now, as I've had a few beers, yes, but like to the girls, I'm not. Like, I'll treat them very, very good.
Do you think he's a toxic guy?
No, he's not. He's super chill.
Do you think, like, tonight, if he asked you, can I hit, you'd let him hit?
And you're lesbian.
Like, no. Tonight, if you had a few more drinks and he said, listen, I want you tonight, would you say yes to him?
Yeah.
There you go, buddy.
Surely.
Hey, you're the man.
Listen, bro, it's all you, bro, so I'm just helping the brother out, isn't it? Bro, she's on you hard, mate.
Fuck, she's...
I cannot wholeheartedly sit here and say that one person, men or women, suffer more in war. Everyone, the people fighting, people on the opposing side, people on whatever side you're on, there are victims in both sides who necessarily don't agree.
Okay, you're in a convenience store and a robber walks in and he steals a Snickers bar from the clerk and then he walks over and beats you half to death and essays you. Who was more victimized?
Me.
So then we can ascertain that there can be levels of victimization.
To me?
Yeah, to you.
I would feel like a pig f***ing victim. The other guy probably also could be stuck with trauma from watching me go.
Do you think
that?
No, he didn't have to see it. He didn't watch it. He just had a Snickers bar stolen from him. Which one of you is more of a victim?
Okay. Everyone's a victim.
You can't ascertain that the guy who lost a Snickers bar has been less victimized than the woman who's been half beaten to death and essayed? Really?
There's no point even arguing with her because every situation she's in, she's the victim, you know? She's got the victim personality and persona, and she carries that through all her different situation and walks in life. And I think she's just too scared to agree. She doesn't want to agree with anyone. I already know that. And if it was the other way around, women going to war and men staying at home, she would easily say that women suffer way more. She's just delusional.
The average man, I mean, these are struggles. Like, if you look at the average, the wage of, what is it, like 50K?
Yeah.
Could you imagine like 50K? Like, I read these numbers, I see these stats, and I see people living, I see people struggling, and I'm like, man, I truly feel for you guys.
Yeah.
And so when you see these people living good lives, not drinking, not cheating, not beating up their wives, being a good father, like the guy, I met a guy in San Diego, and he had two daughters, and he comes up to me, and he starts like, putting me on a pedestal, like, oh my God, you're Sean Strickland. I'm like, dude, you kidding me? Like, you work a hard job. You're really? Married. You have two beautiful daughters that you are raising to be good people. You have done way more in your life than I could ever do. I am nobody to put on a pedestal. You struggle, I don't. You make the world struggle, I don't.
If you don't know who this guy is, it's Sean Strickland. He's a UFC fighter. He's one of the best in the game. And he's always been known for being honest and saying the truth. And you got to respect him for this, for being honorable. Yeah, he's pretty famous. He's made a lot of money. And there's a lot of people who are sort of on his level or a bit lower, whatever, who are just out of touch with reality. And he clearly is in touch with reality. And these are just the comments of a good man and a warrior. So respect to Sean for that one.